In this first video, I'm going to show you how to link test cases from Tosca to qTest, and also how to link test events from Tosca to qTest. So in order to work in Tosca first, you would need a multi-user repository, which I have already set up. I'm not going to show that in this video. I'm going to simply create a new test case folder, and I'm going to name it for now qTosca, as we are talking about qTest Tosca integration, where I'm going to create a simple test case. And just for the example, I'm going to have one step in this test case where it's going to be buffer value qTosca. Nothing interesting or exciting. At this point, once a user has a test case and decides that this test case should be linked to qTest, there are a couple of options. We can trigger the integration task link with qTest on the object itself, or we could actually go for the folder where we can see the same integration task link with qTest. For now, I'm going to just simply go for the test case. At this point, the user will be prompted with a pop-up, which says link with qTest, where you will have to provide connection details. You will have to choose a qTest project, a qTest module, which is in Tosca, basically the test case folder. As you can see, since I've been using this workspace previously as well, and I have my connection details configured, this connection details dropdown is collapsed already. Now that I expanded it, I will see that I have to provide the qTest URL, username and password, and afterwards click save and refresh, and then I will be able to see all my qTest projects. For this example, I'm going to check qTest Tosca integration project, where I see already a couple of qTest modules where I could link this test case. What needs to be mentioned is that when we are saying link, what we mean by that is that this test case will be created in the qTest project, and basically they will be linked by unique properties. So we are creating an actual new test case in the qTest project. Now, just to show you how qTest side is currently looking. So we are in the qTest Tosca integration project, where I have the following modules. As you can see in the qTest manager, in the qTest Tosca integration project, I have access to the same modules and I can see them. Now, just to show that it actually recognizes if I would create a new module, I'm going to call this qTosca. Perfect. And now, if I navigate back to Tosca and click save and refresh, at this point we do refresh, and then you would find the qTest module that you actually wanted to, let's say, link your Tosca test cases to. So I have to do nothing but choose the project, select the qTest module, and click link. And if I navigate now back to my Tosca, at this point, you will find the pop-up. This pop-up says that link with qTest, we are talking about one test case, nothing fancy. But one thing that we have to understand is the actual calls to qTest will be made once the user checks in. The reason for that is that we want to be able to provide consistency between the two tools. And the easiest way and the most straightforward way is to wait until we can check these objects successfully in the common repository. Once that's then we can also make the call to qTest and create the necessary objects. Hitting OK. You will find a couple of properties on the right side, the API endpoint to your qTest instance. If the object is linked already, as I mentioned, you're going to see you're going to find here false. Since the object is not linked yet, you will have to check in. And then module ID, project ID, these are unique IDs on the qTest side, just to find the object as easy as possible. I'll show you in a second why that actually matters. So let's check in all my whole project. At this point, what's going to happen is that link with qTest property turns into true. And also, if you paid attention, then you can find that now that we have an actual object ID, which is the unique object found on the qTest side. So why do we have all these properties? If I right-click on the Tosca test case object already, now you can see that there are different integration properties: viewing qTest, unlink from qTest, updating qTest. For now, even though I have qTest here already opened, and I spoiled it, but you can already find a simple Tosca test case on qTest side. Let's imagine for a second I don't have this window opened, and I'm still in the Tosca side, in the Tosca workspace, and I want to navigate myself to this test case as quickly as possible. As you can see, we have a task viewing qTest. Let me use it. At this point, your default browser will be used, opening the qTest instance with the qTest project and navigating to the actual object what you've just created. Of course, now it doesn't ask me any credentials because I'm already logged in, but if it would be the first time, then qTest would ask for your credentials. I'm just closing the other browser in the meantime. And what you can see here is that these Tosca test cases on qTest side, they are flagged with automation and Tosca flags. These are simply meaning that this is a test case which is meant to be automated and it is coming from Tosca. That is one way to link test cases. Of course, it can happen that accidentally or not accidentally, but we link a test case which we don't want to have in qTest anymore. So what can a user do in this case? In order to keep the two tools consistent and not have any issues in the future, the recommended workflow is that before you delete any objects on Tosca side, you would unlink them from qTest. How does that look like? Simply right-click on the object. Of course, I could do it on the folder root as well. And now I would choose unlink from qTest integration task. At which point, again, a very familiar window shows up. The connection details, of course, collapse since you provided them already once. Where you have a potentially option to click on delete link test cases in qTest. What it means is that the test case which we just created on the qTest side in Tosca, since Tosca is the master tool, you could also choose to delete it immediately. Or if for some reason you would like to keep this test case on the qTest side for historical purposes, you would like to keep the data there, you could simply keep it unchecked and just click on unlink. For now, I'm going to check it as I don't need it on the qTest side and click unlink. Now, if I check in, and the check-in finishes successfully, you will see that the properties on the right side are missing, meaning that the unlink is successful. And now if I refresh, most likely qTest will tell me that the object is not found anymore. The page is invalid, perfect. So let me just navigate back to test design section into my qTosca module, where you can see that even after trying to show all the objects below, they are not visible. And that would be it in a very short demo, how to link a test case and how to unlink it in case you would not want to have it in qTest anymore.